With over 60 Tamil, Telugu, Malayalam and Kannada movies under her cap, 2 Filmfare Awards, a Tamil Nadu State Film Award and a Cinema Award for Best Supporting Actress in Khadgam and Pithamagan.
స్క్రీన్ మీద నన్ను నేను చూసుకోవాలి ఎలాయినా పెద్ద హీరోయిన్ అవ్వాలి
అండ్ మోర్ దెన్ 220k ట్విట్టర్ ఫాలోవర్స్ అండ్ గ్రోయింగ్ రసిక ఆఫ్ ద సిల్వర్ స్క్రీన్
ఒక్క ఛాన్స్ ఓకే ఒక్క ఛాన్స్
I am so pleased to invite our celebrity guest, Sangeeta Krish. So, Sangeeta ma'am, you are looking absolutely stunning in blue, just like a royal queen. How are you feeling in Melbourne?
I'm feeling great. This is my first trip, and I'm feeling very warm with everyone's love, and hospitality is fantastic. I'm feeling just perfect.
That's exactly what we want to hear. Can you say something about your film career? What are the highlights?
Well, it's been 22 years now. It's the 23rd year. So that by itself is an achievement, I feel, because standing here for 23 long years and working, I feel great.
It doesn't feel like that you've been for so long. You still look so young. So both your father and grandfather are producers, right? So how was it, and you have two brothers as well, so was it difficult to have your own identity as a girl, and for a person as talented as you are, was it hard to express your artistic feelings? Was it different?
No, see, I mean, we belong to a producer's family, but then none of them have come on screen. I was the first person because I think when my mom was very beautiful and there were a lot of offers pouring in for her, but then my grandfather didn't accept. So probably I think today I'm here as an actress because of my mother. You know, I think it was her dream which she pursued through me, and whatever I am today is because of her. And I feel really grateful, and God has been really kind. And when I joined film industry, I was just 14 or something. I was a kid, and then he's given me such long years, and there was so much of time for trial and error, and I've learned so much in the process, and I'm very happy about whatever I am today as an actress and as a woman.
That's really rightly said. Family support is very important. Now, I know you have two brothers. How was it growing up with them? Did you fight a lot? Who used to win? And can you just tell me something about your experiences with them?
My older brother is almost 9 years older than me, so he's like a father to me. I lost my dad when I was really young.
Oh, that's
so
sad.
So he was like a father to me. And my second brother is 2 years older than me, and so we fight a lot. And we still keep fighting. Never ends.
That is nice. Siblings are there for that.
Yeah.
Ma'am, every woman in their life, they want to meet their Prince Charming, somebody who could come on a horse and sweep them off their feet. So when was that moment for you when Krish sir did something to impress you?
Well, it was in an award function. We met in Vijay Awards, and I was there to present him best singer award, mm-hmm. best singer male award, and yep. I was on stage and I presented the award. I didn't know who this guy was, and then I came down and I was just watching him perform the moment I gave him the award, and he was fabulous on stage, and that's when they were looking out for me at my place. So and I was just rejecting every single offer which was coming to me. I said no. My mom was like, well, it's a big family, he's a nice guy, and I was like no. My mom was like, what's wrong with you? And she was like, suddenly she had a doubt, and she was asking me, are you really wanting to get married or you just want to stay like this? And I said, yeah, I'm wanting to get married, but then you're rejecting every single proposal which is coming to you. I said, I don't know, I'm not able to connect. And then I saw this guy on stage performing, and I just told my mother, this is how I want the guy to be. Can you live? You were asking me, right?
Yeah.
So I'm telling you, he's the guy. You know, I want a guy like that. And then finally I'm married to him. Yeah, okay. I just wished for it, and God granted
me. Both of you are lucky and deserve each other.
Thank you.
I'm sure most of the viewers will agree with me when I say that we want to see you and Chris doing something in collaboration, like maybe a music video. Is there a chance that we could see something like that in the future? Like
no.
You could be doing Bhartanatyam and he could be singing to you?
No, no. We have decided day one, the day we tied the knot, we decided that we will never show other personal side of ours on screen, that we would never perform anything together, because we wanted to keep that part of our life really private. We don't want to exhibit our relationship on screen. Unless and until it's completely inevitable and you cannot, you know, avoid it. Yeah. A situation like that occurs, fine. If not, we would try 99.9% not to come on screen together. Because I feel certain things remains valuable only when it's private. So we treasure this relationship, we treasure this marriage, our family, and we have a lot of values. And we decided that we will never come on public and in any kind of a public forum together.
That is such a sweet thing to say. It's nice to keep those spaces separate, as you said. It's very important.
So we don't want people to judge us, our relationships, and us as a couple.
True.
So we decided to stay away from media.
Because being a celebrity is easy for people to talk about everything you do.
Exactly.
True. Now for a very serious, not serious, but a sad question. The world has lost a most precious and beautiful soul last month. Sridevi Garu is no more with us. How was the atmosphere surrounding this great loss?
It is a great loss to the film industry by itself, because all of us as kids have taken her as an inspiration. Today, if you ask 90% of the actresses, the heroines, they would definitely name Sridevi for the reason behind their inspiration, or for them to be an actor today. They've all 99.9%, I think most of them will just utter her name.
True.
Without even a hesitation, and I'm one among that.
Yeah.
I'm one among them, and I love her and I know her personally. She's such a sweet human being and such a fabulous, effortless, you mean, I cannot say effortless, because in every single thing what she does,
perfection.
She's so perfect. Yeah. And she's so gorgeous. She puts in so much into the way she looks, her style and everything. Her dedication at this age just stunned me. I was like stunned over her dedication. And I'm still not able to come in terms with that, because I haven't seen her. I was shooting away and I didn't see her models, and it's still not sinking into me.
It's
really, really a big blow to all of us. And I was really scared. Anything. See, this is suddenly, it's pushed us to the point that anything might happen anytime. So just live the moment.
Very true.
Just enjoy every single thing God has blessed you with.
Very true.
So be thankful to every single thing what God has given you. So don't crib, because you don't know what is going to happen tomorrow. Who is going to be there with you and who's not going to be. It's nothing is in your hands. So life is so uncertain. And just live your day.
True. So true. What's the one thing that you want to tell people who have nothing but just passion to get into this film industry?
I mean, I am a passionate person, but I am also a very practical person. I would say, yes, go behind your passion, but yes, have an alternate career too, because, earlier there were very few people who were coming in, and there were very less people who were like wanting to join film industry. Now the entire world wants to be a celebrity.
True.
They want to be an actor or something like that, you know. So the competition,
the
competition is so high now, and sustaining here is, for that matter, in any field, whether you're a singer or you're a dancer or you're a director or you're a, there is probably just one in a crore who's leading a very successful and a very safe life. Even them, you know, continuously or 10 flops, they're nowhere. So it is very difficult to sustain in this place. I would say that don't lose your heart, because I'm seeing a lot of children, a lot of youngsters coming in with so much of passion and getting depressed and then getting into wrong habits and lose their life, lose everything what they have, and finally dejected. And some people even killing, going to the extent of committing suicide, killing themselves. I get very scared. If someone is asking me, I said, no, don't come in. Unless and until you are balanced and you're able to understand this is how it will be, and, you know, take it in the right way. whether it's a failure or a success, be balanced. So I would suggest them, first don't come. If at all you come, have a balanced mind and stay strong, because the whole world is going to be against you and you have to swim against the tide.
Wise words, Sangeeta. Really wise words. Can you please tell us some of your favorite or famous dialogues from those, any movies that you really like? Your fans.
I'll say this dialogue is obviously everyone loves. It's from Kadgu.
Yep. I was hoping you say that.
Okay, chance.
Oh, guys, I could die for that. That's my favorite, you know, that Sita Mahalakshmi, the character that you've done. Oh, so innocent and naive. There are lots of people like that really out there.
Yeah, I know that. I mean, when I was uttering the dialogue, even I was in that state, waiting for success to hit on me. But then I never thought that dialogue would become so popular.
It is quite popular after all these years too. People still remember it and know you for that. The most memorable moment in any woman's life is the birth of her child. What was it for you? Was it your first movie, Gangotri, or your first Filmfare Award for Khadgam movie? Or was it seeing your daughter for the first time?
Obviously, see, I'm an actress and everything is out of my system now. The one thing which fills me today is being a mother, and I'm a complete mother. I just love my daughter
immensely.
And
I can see that you're missing her.
Yes, and she is my life, and for that matter, even for Krish, for both of us, she is the apple of our eye, and I just love being a mother. The first thing I remember seeing her opening my eyes, and I just told my husband, "Oh, she looks just like me."
That's the best feeling.
Yeah, I said, what the hell? She's looking just like me. And he was like, "No, she looks like me." I was like, "No, she looks like me." And we started arguing on that. So I can never forget that moment. And she gives us so much of happiness. And there's a lot of meaning to our life now.
Beautiful. Who decided on the name?
It was like both of us, like we both are staunch Lord Shiva's devotees. Lord Shiva's, so we decided that if it's a boy, we'll name after him. And if it's a girl, obviously, you know, half the name would be Lord Shiva, and which would just change a little bit. Like,
sound like a
probably
girl's
Ishwar
name.
Will be Ishwari or something like that. Yeah. So we're looking out for a lot of names.
It's a very unique name, actually.
And then we were not satisfied. We were like on and on because everything was so complicated. We wanted something short and simple. Not too complicated. And then finally I read Divya as Shivya. Somewhere it was written and it read as Shivya. And I looked at immediately I called my husband and said, "How is Shivya?" He said, "Wow, I like the name." And then everyone said, "Wow, wow, wow, wow." And then I took the paper and it was an invitation. I just took it close and I just saw it and it read as Divya. I said, "But not bad. Probably God has just shown me this name and said, go ahead." And I took it as a sign from
It's actually a very cute name.
And then we named her Shivya after
Shivya. It's a very perfect name for somebody who loves Lord Shiva.
And if you ask her, like, "Ninga yaroda pulla amma?" appdi ketana, "Na Shivanoda pulla adha enak Shivya nu per vechirukkaru."
Romba smart.
She said, "Na kadavul pulla."
Very true. So what are you buying for her? Any gifts? Do you have anything in mind that you want to take it back?
Oh, I must talk about my daughter now, because if I ask her, "What do you want?" she says, "Nothing."
Really?
She's one kid who's like fascinated me, shocked me, because even if I take her into a toy store, the biggest toy store, she'll just go, she'll look at everything, she'll play with everything, said, "Amma, come, let's go."
Very nice.
She's such a darling.
You're a lucky mother.
And probably that makes us buy more things for her, because she's not asking us anything. She never asks for anything.
Or
probably the maximum she would say is like, if she likes something, she'll just point her and say, "Amma, enakku idu vaangi tharingla." I'll be like, okay. The next thing I would think is it worth? Will she use it? This is what comes into my mind. By the time I'm thinking, she's like, "Ippa venda." அப்புறம் உங்களுக்கு பணம் வரப்ப எனக்கு வாங்கிட்டாங்க. That's the second statement. It's like she thinks that, you know, we're broke and we not fit to buy anything. The second thing is, "உங்களுக்கு எப்ப முடியுமோ நீங்க வாங்கிட்டாங்க அம்மா, நோ ப்ராப்ளம்." by then we get into the car, even she forgets and we forget. That's it, it's done.
Such a sweet
child. The first time she asked me something was a spinner.
The fidget spinner.
Fidget spinner. And it's like she's like, Amma, spinner. Buy me that. I was like, well, how much is this? It's 100 bucks. Oh, 100
by 100.
100 rupees. And she's like, okay, baby, you want one more? No, ma. One is enough. I'm like, okay, this kid is slightly weird. Because I wasn't like that, and my husband is worse because I heard it from my in-laws that he would ask for everything in the world.
Oh, just the opposite then.
Yes.
Yeah, so ma'am, I know you're a very strong lady now, you've got a daughter too. What message do you have for all those women out there who have been a victim of domestic violence for many reasons, like dowry harassment or not being able to bear a son or just being in an abusive relationship? What do you have to say to them?
Just get out of it. Simple. Live your life. You're not here to be a slave, or you're not here to take so much in life. I mean, all women are so beautiful. You're so blessed. And I don't think you should be taking anything from anyone in any manner. Live your life, be strong, be proud about whatever you are, irrespective of what people talk about you. I think you should just move on with your life. You will be blessed in some other way.
But according to you, how and where does woman empowerment really begin?
I mean, I don't believe. I'm not a feminist. I'm not. It's not like I talk about women all the time. It's like everything's women. It's not. It's very balanced.
Yes.
I prefer a man do his duties and women do her duties.
True.
And yes, just get together. If the family requires, go ahead and live your life.
True.
And just enjoy. I'm not too much into this, you know, empowerment and live life, nothing. I don't believe in such things. You like to do something, do it. If you don't like to do something, don't do it. So you don't force yourself because the whole world is going behind something. See, I love to do something, I like to do it. And my entire family loves what I'm doing, and so I'm doing it. If they don't like doing it, maybe I will not do it to that extent. Mm. But yes, of course, I will do something for myself. So everything, I mean, I don't think you can judge a situation or you can generalize a statement or anything. Do if you like. Be
so
successful.
It's all about balance?
Yes, everything. It's like too much of women. No, I don't believe in that too. And I don't believe in someone dominating, or sitting on your head and dominating. No. I don't believe in that too. It's like I feel gender equality has to stick into everyone's mind. And please, to all the mothers, start inculcating in that into your children, into your sons. Make them beautiful, you know, grow them in a way that they will respect every single woman around. And I think that's the baseline. Whatever is corrupted right now, let it just end with that. At least the next generation bring in so much of love, peace, and respect to all the women around.
So whatever, it starts at home and empower your children. That's where it starts. Have equal balance between both men and women, and it's all about teamwork.
Yes, learn to respect. Teach them to respect every single soul around. That's it. Whether it's a woman or whether it's a girl child or a boy, let them learn to respect each other.
I love you for what you're saying, because I think the same thing too. Finally, Sangeeta ma'am, how do you feel about being here for Rani Maharani, presented by MDA Events? What was your expectation for the night, and did it satisfy you?
See, Mandy's a very good friend of mine, and we love her for her energy and enthusiasm and everything. When she called me, I said, yes, I'll definitely come in. And I did accept this long back. But then it fell around a very, very tight schedule of my life, and right now I'm just shuttling up and down. So it came to a point where it was so difficult for me to attend, but then I didn't want to disappoint her. I didn't want to disappoint anyone. I wanted to come here because it is something what I've accepted long back and agreed to come on. And so I came, and now there's no regret, because it's so beautiful to meet all of you all here. And there's all these wonderful ladies who I met today. It's so much of energy and happiness. I mean, see, all of us are stuck in a routine life. It's just, you know, eat, I mean, wake up, cook, eat, sleep, run, work. It's just around that. And it is a chance for all the women to come unwind themselves. Yeah. I mean, sing, dance, talk, laugh. I mean, it's so much of, it was so positive. And I you know, I just landed last night. I'm still jet lagging and I'm leaving tomorrow. But then I feel really energized. Looking at everyone's smile and happiness, this whole atmosphere was like, you know, it was glowing. It is not a very professional, a hi-fi show, but it's a very homely and personalized event, which I enjoyed more. I really had fun. I enjoyed, I want to congratulate all the women who came out and who expressed themselves out, who just enjoyed and who participated in everything. I mean, see, winning, losing, all those things is respective, you know, it's very secondary. But coming and participating and making this place so lively is what matters, and they really, truly deserve a big round of applause for doing that. And I should thank MDA Events for calling us over. Now I feel energized and I'm going back to my shoot with all the energy, and I'm going to start my schedule again.
I'm glad Melbourne can do that for you. Thank
you
very much.
Thank you so much.
Finally, can you please say something for Army TV viewers?
Thank you so much for this whole thing and coming over, and I had great fun, and I wanted to wish you all the very best to Me TV, and continue the great job and rock on.
Thank you so much, Sangeeta ma'am. It was such a pleasure talking to you. I hope you can continue doing your beautiful work and inspiring women throughout the world. Safe travels, and please give our love and regards to your family from all of us here in Australia and Me TV.
Thank you so much. Even I love talking to you and talking to your viewers. Wishing you all a very happy Women's Day. Women rock.